Hey everybody, welcome back. We're coming to you tonight from the Scott Trade Center in St. Louis. Tomorrow night, the Indiana State Sycamores will kick off Arch Madness against the University of Evansville.
The festivities got going this afternoon at the Coach of the Year luncheon. There was speculation that Greg Lansing would be in line for the award after leading a team picked 7th to a 3rd place finish in the league. Coach did not take home the hardware. Instead, it went to Konzo Martin, who led the Missouri State Bears to their first ever league title.
So Lansing doesn't get Coach of the Year, and the 3rd place Sycamores place no one on the 1st or 2nd all-conference teams. You'd think they were flying under the radar, but the coaches of the top 2 finishing teams in this league disagree.
Well, I mean, I think on the periphery they're flying under the radar, but not in this league. I mean, every coach knows they bring to the table.
And they've had a wonderful year, a third seed in the tournament, won a lot of close games, and they've got a lot of good talent from freshmen on through their senior class, led by Aaron Carter. So I just think that they're a very well-balanced team. Give anybody problems, it's a wide-open field, so they're a good team.
Coach of the Year Konzo Martin thinks ISU's lack of presence on the all-conference squads is just a compliment to the balance that they bring to the floor.
It's not necessarily strange that they don't have anybody in first, second team because they did such a good job across the board. And I think what happens when you're probably trying to vote, Jake took over and did so many great things, but, maybe he's a freshman. Carl did some good things. I mean, so they had Carl did some good things. So it's one of those deals, like, who do you vote for? Because they all play so well together. So.
Jake Odom and Carl Richard are honorable mention all-conference players. Coach Lansing took a team picked to finish 7th, led them to a 3rd place finish in the league without Jake Kelly and Dwayne Lathan for large stretches of the season. And he took a back seat in the Coach of the Year voting to Martin. There you have it, straight from the mouths of the coaches whose teams finished at the top of this conference. No one inside the Valley is taking the Sycamores lightly. Tomorrow night, they'll tip off at 9:35 against Evansville to try to start turning a few heads, maybe even prove a few voters wrong. Tomorrow night, high school boys basketball sectionals continue. We'll have 12 games for you on In the Paint. Of course, the highlighted game is Terre Haute North against Terre Haute South. These two rivals will meet for the 3rd time this season at the semifinals of the Northview Sectional. North has won the first 2 meetings this season against South, but it has been far from easy for the Patriots in those wins. Especially in their last matchup, with the shoe on the line, North won in overtime 46-45 when Anthony McGill's shot just rimmed out to give the Patriots the win. Ever since that heartbreaking loss in the shoe game, the Braves said they have wanted another shot at the Patriots.
I think we got cheated on that last shot. I've seen Anthony hit that shot so many times, though. But I think we can get him in the sectionals.
We kind of think of it as you don't have to beat him 3 times in a row. You just have to beat him this one time to get along. So we're trying to get focused for just this one game, not worry about what happened in the past.
And, of course, we continue to prepare for that all Wabash Valley state championship. It's Vincennes Reveille against Turkey Run. Sports 10 was out at Turkey Run practice earlier this week. Coach Thompson has the girls loose, feeling good about their chances. Of course, if you remember back to December 29th, Turkey Run lost to Vincennes Reveille, but coach admitted they didn't play very well in the first half, still made it an 8-point ball game. These 7 seniors for Turkey Run have been playing together since 2nd grade, and they think that the only way to end this successfully is to take home a state title.
That's every little girl's dream, to play in a state championship. And ever since we were in the 2nd grade, this is what we wanted. This is what, we prayed about at night. This is everything to us, so we're really looking forward to it.
That would be the ultimate way to end my season. I want to go home crying, happy tears, I wish I would have done something better.
Of course, Sports 10 will bring you all the coverage you need to have from that state championship game. Should be a great matchup. And here at Scott Trade, we're excited for the Sycamores to kick off Arch Madness. That does it for Sports News 10. We'll be right back.